I'd now like to hear a few things from our AmeriCorps volunteers. I'd like to introduce Nick, Anna, Katie, and Lauren. They'll be telling us a little bit about what AmeriCorps is doing in this area.
I'm here today to tell you a little bit about a campus organization called AmeriCorps. AmeriCorps is on UL's campus and is affiliated directly through the university. The purpose of AmeriCorps is to have an outreach to the community as a collegiate community service organization. We do many different community service projects ranging from educational with Alice Boucher. We do housing projects dealing with Habitat for Humanity and ramps and rails. And we also do a large amount of group projects and different many types of training. AmeriCorps' main goal is to engage college students like us, to immerse us into the community so that we ourselves can see the different needs and concerns that the community may have. Even though our organization may not be large in numbers, there's about 45 members on us, on the team this year, we do a large amount of work in a short amount of time. There's many different aspects to our team. There's different types of personalities that everyone possesses that brings into a large pot of people, and it's amazing to see how all these personalities can come together to complete one huge service project. Each of my teammates here are going to talk a little bit about their primary sites and service, and I'm going to turn it over to Katie, and she's going to talk to you about ramps and rails and Habitat for Humanity.
Two of the main organizations that we work with as an organization is Habitat for Humanity Acadiana and also Rebuilding Together Acadiana. Habitat for Humanity primarily works with new construction. They have people, mostly women, single moms, women and children that are living in housing that doesn't meet their current needs, and they, through a loan process, qualify for a new home. Habitat for Humanity actually holds the loan for them and is able to provide them a home that generally appraises in the $100,000 range for about $70,000, and they finance it, so they're able to make monthly payments around $400 a month. So you're taking people who are living in substandard houses and they're able to live in a very nice brand new home. And the reason that they're able to do that is because of the labor force that is provided. Instead of paying for the labor, they're only having to pay for the materials, basically. We work every week. Our students, our UL AmeriCorps is out there working on site. And we are able to bring that cost down, which allows these homes to be affordable for these families. The neatest thing, and one of the things I love most about working with Habitat for Humanity in particular, is you're getting to work right alongside the homeowners, the people who are actually going to live in these homes. I've gotten to know them. You get to hear their stories, and it brings so much purpose to the labor that you're putting into these homes. And then I've actually gotten to attend the home dedication days. And so when you've gotten to know these people, and then you're there on the day that they're cutting the ribbon and they get their keys and they unlock that door for the first time to their first brand new home, it's moving and it's so gratifying. And while it's very hard work, it's so incredible to see the life change that you've been able to be a part of. Working with Rebuilding Together of Acadiana, they're somewhat the same and a little bit different. They work more with existing structures. They work with low-income elderly and disabled people. One of their primary construction projects that they work on is wheelchair ramps, and we've built quite a bit of those. Our team's built 14 of them last year in the nine-month school year, and we also work on minor repairs and updates on the housing to help them have more livable living standards. And it's the neatest thing to be a part of. And another area that we work on is at Alice Boucher, and I'll let Anna talk a little bit about that and some of the other things that we do in the program.
So at Alice Boucher Elementary, we just work with the children that are there. This year I'm working with a kindergarten class, and we just go in and sort of get to know the kids on a personal basis. Instead of just helping them with their schoolwork, we also help them deal with everyday struggles if we can. And in addition to all of this cool work that we get to do, we also get trained in a lot of different areas. We completed our first aid CPR training already this year. We'll also complete project planning and management. Each member in our organization, we have to join a group towards the end of the year, and we organize our own group project. We create our own service project. A couple of the ones that we've done are we take the students from Alice Boucher Elementary to UL to show them what they can do with the rest of their lives if they so choose. And another one is the Cinderella Project of Lafayette, where we collect gently used and new prom dresses, and we give them to girls who otherwise wouldn't get to go to their high school prom. And we do a lot of other trainings as well, and we also have a team meeting every other Friday, so we don't just do the work, we get to know each other as well, and we get to really, really, really close. And I'll turn it over to Lauren for our service projects.
So although we are based out of Lafayette, we do a little traveling. So we take service trips, week-long service trips, which it's really exciting for us because we finally get to all be together and work together on this one thing and just get it accomplished. So last fall, we do a fall and spring 2 year, and last fall we went to New Orleans, and we had three projects that we tackled. We re-sheetrocked a whole guy's house. Sorry, I wasn't part of that project, but we had done that, and he was still recovering over Katrina, which was incredible for us to realize that. And then we also worked for a community center in the 9th Ward, and we helped facilitate and organize a Christmas party, and one of our members was Santa Claus.
Yeah.
And it was just amazing to see the smiles on the children's faces whenever they saw Santa.
And they all got presents and everything.
Yeah, and we also worked at a Head Start. So those are three things that we did in New Orleans. And in the spring, we responded to disaster relief to a man who lost his home due to a tornado and rain. So we worked for a week-long revenerating a house that he got from someone in the community, mm-hmm. because his house was completely destroyed. So by the end of the week, we had everything done, and it was livable for him. So we make difference within a week-long on something really big.
And we are always looking for volunteers, and we are located, we're actually a part of UL, and we're right on campus, and we have a website where it's linked to the UL website. We also have our own website, so if you're ever looking for a place to go and give some of your time, we have so many great things that you can be a part of. So thank you for your time. We appreciate you listening to us, and hopefully we've given you some information and maybe some things to think about going and helping to give back to your community. So we appreciate you.